Hi everyone, it's Steph here from feancards.blogspot.co.uk, and I'm here to share with you a project that I've made previously on my blog, but I haven't done a YouTube tutorial for it. And what it is, it's a little hold here, and you just open it like that, and in each section it houses some beautiful little simple birthday cards. I think it's really, really nice just to be able to put in your bag. And if you know, we all have that where we forget it's someone's birthday and we need a card super quick. So I just thought that this would be lovely just to keep inside your bag. And it also has matching envelopes as well. And the cards, I've made them so they fit a gift card inside as well. So if you want to use them to gift a gift card, then I think that would be a really nice idea. I'm doing it in different colourways today. Just pop that to one side. And I'm going to share with you some of the stuff that's now available as a celebration item up until the 31st of March. These are new items, well, from the main catalogue, but they are on there. You can earn this product if you spend £45, and you can pop this in your basket for free. Only thing I will say is if you head on over to my blog and use the code for each of, like, for the festive birthday pack, sorry, not the festive birthday, this is Party Animals DSP. And I'll just show you. I haven't got a lot of it left. It comes in two different designs, obviously all double-sided. I love this so much. I have used it quite a bit. It's very, very versatile. And I just think it's really pretty. I've got one there with cakes on. And then the reverse is lots of candles. A nice stripe. You could use this for a masculine card as well. Nice bright one there with lots of balloons. And the last one is all different coloured spots and numbers on the back. And also another item that you can get as a celebration item until the 31st of this month is the in colour cardstock. This is the Emerald Envy out of there. And this is really good. I'll sure be putting some of this on as my celebration item. So I've changed the measurements up slightly for this box. What we've got here is a piece of card that measures 10 5/8 by 4 inches. Then what you want to do is you want to score it at 2 3/4, 3 1/2, 6 3/8, and 7 3/4. So we'll just go ahead and burnish that. Emerald Envy is one of my favourite colours. Never thought I was a green person, but this colour, I just absolutely love it. Goes with so many things as well. Right, so that's there. Then also in my previous blog post, I used a sheet of 12 by 12, but what I've done is I've cut it down so we can use A4, so you can actually use your celebration freebie to make this project. So we just need to add an extra little flap here, and this measures 4 inches by 3 1/8. And on the 3 1/8 side, you want to score it at 5/8 of an inch and 1 7/8 of an inch. So just go ahead and burnish that as well. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to mitre the small flap in quite a bit, because this is going to fit on the back of here like that. And then we can use our DSP to cover that, to hide the workings. Also, I want to round the corners of these. So because I've made some little cards and we're going to be doing some envelopes, I'm going to show you how to make a couple of the envelopes on camera as well. So this side here is a corner rounder. And as you can see, it just gives a lovely finish. Just bring all that rubbish out the way. And what we'll do is we'll stick this flap. Going to use double-sided tape just to make sure it doesn't go anywhere. Really excited to see how this will turn out, because I love these papers, and like I said, Emerald Envy is definitely one of my favourites. Flirty Flamingo and Sweet Sugar Plum, also cloth ones as well, for my favourites in the new in colours, the 2016 to 2018. Right, so what we want to do is we want to go double side tape here, And you want to line this. Let's turn it around the other way so I can see properly. And you want to line it up just under the score line. Make sure it's equal at both sides. And then just stick that down like that. That here. So what will happen is once we stick the box on here, here and here, you will fold that round like that and that will form like your shell. So the next thing, I'll put that to one side for the time being, and what I'll do is I'll show you how to make the box for the cards and envelopes to fit in. This measures, I haven't wrote it down, this measures 3.5 by 5.5. And then you want to score it at, that's 3/8 of an inch, 1 second, I'm not very prepared. On the long side, score it at 3/8 of an inch and 3/4 of an inch. Turn it round and do the same 3/8 of an inch and 3/4 of an inch on the other side. Then if you turn it on the short side and score it at 3/8 of an inch and 3/4 of an inch again, and then just fold and burnish. These done as I get my fingers to work. And there's just a little bit of cutting away to do on this one. There we go. So they're all full and burnished. Then what we have here, these four little squares here, you want to cut up that first score line to that score line, and then remove the bottom two squares. Oh. It's a bit like doing a reinforced box. And then just cut this end square away like that. And then just slightly mitre in to make a tab like that. And we do the same on the next side along. Cut up the score line, cut away the bottom two, and then cut away this end square. Oh. And then mitre in like we did on the opposite side. So we'll be left with something that looks like that. Now what I like to do at this point, I like to put my DSP panel on because it's easier than doing it. So this is the one I've chose for this one. I've got different ones on each of the sections. And this one, it might be this one here. Yeah, this one's better. This measures 3 7/8 by 2 5/8. And I'm just going to go and use some Tombow to attach this. Tombow to work. It should be working. I've just used it on a previous project. Oh, it doesn't want to come out. Sorry about this. With me poly tool, that's better. Whatever happens to you, just stick your poly tool in it or a pin and that should sort it out. So just line that up as straight as you can and just put that down like that. And that looks good to me. So what we're going to do now is I've used a 2-inch circle punch just to make a little finger hole so you can get the cards out. Mine isn't stamping up. I haven't actually got that yet. It's on my knee to get. So just lined up where you think the centre is. Oh, and just punch. And you'll be left with something that looks like that. Now what we want to do is we want to attach a little bit of double-sided tape onto these tabs. I was going to use my fast fuse, but I think that's a bit too small for me to get in there, so I just stuck with tape this time. And then what I've done was I turned it over and I popped a little bit of just a single strip going down each side here as well. Right, so bottom. Use my putty tool. Take off the backing paper. And then what you want to do is you just want to get that tab and line that up as if you were making a box, and then that just sticks in like that. And then do the same on the side. Then these two side bits fold in, and we need to take off the backing of this little bit here. And then just push that round. Make sure it's square, you can just give it a little press with your thumbs. A little bit sticking out there, just trim that bit off, make sure it's nice and neat. And that there is what our cards and envelopes is going to sit in. And for purposes of the video, I've went ahead and I've done another two. And obviously once you've done them, you just want to stick some double-sided tape along the back here, on the sides, ready to attach them to our sleeve. I hope you think I'm getting better at videos. I still feel like super nervous every time I come and do one. It's pathetic really, but you know, I can't help that. Right, so we'll just leave them there for the time being. We'll bring back our sleeve. And what I want to do is obviously I have got some panels to cover these bits here, and then panels to fit over the three sections at the back. So what I like to do is, like say if I'm going to put that one, attach that one on here, I like to put the same DSP on the other side. So that's what we'll do now. So I've got the presents paper. And these measure the same as the front of what's on the boxes, which is 3 7/8 by 2 5/8. So just line that up on here. Hold it just for a couple of seconds. And if you want, you can run over it with your bone folder to make sure it's stuck down nice and strong. So then that one goes like that. This one will need to be the opposite way. And I'm going to put the green one in the middle, so that one's going to be like this. It's all which, when it's folded up, all of the patterns go in the right direction. This was actually inspired by another product I found in the Disney shop. As much as I love Stampin' Up, I'm just as bad with the Disney shop, especially when they have sales on. I'm so bad, I can't help myself. But I have gotten a lot of bargains and some nice presents for people out of there, so it's all good. Right, so that one goes like that. So this one needs to face the opposite way again, and I'm using the candles, and that's just going to stick on here like that. Oh, I'm right out of the camera shot here. I apologise, I keep forgetting. Right, so that's just on there. Let's make sure it's nice and stuck down with my bone folder. And then what will I do next one? We'll put the DSP on these top bits here. And for the top, I'm using the birthday candles. That one's going to go on here, and this measures 3 7/8 by 1 1/8, as does the one for the flap. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get my envelope punch board again and just round them corners so it sits in nicely. There we go. So once I put that on, knocking everything all over, that will just sit on there nicely like that, giving it a lovely little border. So I'll get these stuck down. I've also cut an extra one of these strips without rounding the corners, and I'm going to pop that on the inside, which we will do after I've stuck these down. that. And then the one I've got is just using the spot design this time, and I'm just going to pop that on there so it looks pretty when you open it. So that just sits in here like that. Right, now what we're going to do is so that's what it looks like so far. I think it looks super cute, I hope you agree. So what we'll do now is we're going to attach our boxes. So this one was the top one, so we're going to pop that on here, and we're going to put it just before the score line so it will not affect in the closure. So let's take off the release paper here on our little holders. If you want to, you could use Tombow, you get a little bit more wiggle room with some wet glue. Just make sure it's lined up and nicely. Just move that out of the way for a second, and I'm just going to get my bone folder in there just to make sure, and that is your first one. Then this one, go and do the same again and pop that down on the middle section. I think the longest part of this is deciding what, you know, patterns you want to play with and stuff like that, because it's not a long project. Once you've got everything set up and you've got everything in place. Right, so again, we're just going to line that up on there like that. And stick our bone folder in. And what you'll see is when you fold it up like that, the all will sit just really nice and straight together. So last box. We're not far off finished really. I've already pre-made the cards, but I'll show you them in a second. And I'm going to make a couple of envelopes with you on camera as well, just in case you haven't seen our envelope punch board or anything like that, but I just thought I'd share that with you as well. Right now, that's a bit tricky, just make sure you're lining that up right at the bottom. I'm sticking it a little bit down now, though, I can't do anything about it. Take your bone folder in, looking everything all over. So then, when you fold it up, that's it. Just nice and square with your three things there. Excuse me. What I used to close my box was a Velcro dot that I had in my stash. Just cheap enough to buy them. And what I'd done was I cut it in half, like so. And then what we'll do is, these are self-adhesive as well, so you don't need to put any extra glue on. Just get all the rubbish off my fingers first. And then, it's coming off. 1 second. So then all I've done was I just put that on here like that, leaving the two parts attached. Get rid of that rubbish. It's stuck to me. And then all you want to do is just line that up and press down like that. And then when you take it off, that one's going to be cockeyed. It'll be fine. And that is how it will close. Right, so for my cards I've made, these cards measure 2.5 by 3.5. So, and they're just really cute. There's nothing really on the inside. They just, I've done three of each because I think three and envelopes will fit in quite nicely. That's my first one. Used the Open Me already. I'll show you the stamp set I've used. And this is from the same suite in the catalogue. And this is the Balloon Adventures. And what I've used is, on the present one, I've used Oat Me already. And then on this one here, which is the silhouettes of the animals, I've used It's Your Birthday, and I've used the decorative label punch there just to punch that out. And then on this one, I've done this one really, really simple. Just stamped a sentiment onto it. No one deserves a happy birthday than you. And then I've cut down some of the candle DSP and then just mounted it on a bit of Emerald Envy. And I just think it looks really nice. Just nice and petite. I think I've lost, oh no, there, I've lost him. Right, and I've also made some envelopes to match as well, using the envelope punch board. So these are the ones I've done already. Just made the envelopes and then I've punched out some of the decorative labels so you can write on who it's to. So what I'll do is I've still got two to do. So we'll just pop that out the way. We'll bring our envelope punch board in and we will get these done. This is brilliant. It has loads of measurements on here in inches, and it tells you what size paper you need, where you need to score it at. Comes with its own bone folder as well. And like I said earlier on, this side here is to round the corners. Right, so to make a 2.5 by 3.5 envelope, we need a piece of DSP that measures 5.5 by 5.5. And what you're going to do is you're just going to line up on here at 2 3/8, just like that. Then you're just going to punch it, and then there's a, just use your bone folder and score down here. Then you rotate it, and then this little pointer here, you line that up on the score line you've just made. Make sure it's, and then punch and score. Then keep on doing that all the way around. Punch and score. And then the last one for this envelope, punch and score. Now what I'll do is I'll just quickly do the next one as well. So again, you lined up at 2 3/8, punch and score. Line that with the pointer, punch and score. Last one now, punch and score. Just get rid of that mess here. And then what we'll just do, we'll just pop these in here and we'll just round off those corners there. Just give it a nice smooth finish. The other one. Do that as well. And there we go. Right, so we can get our punch board out of the way now because I'm to be finished with that. Then just take your bone folder and just fold and burnish all of the scores lines you've just made. You can use all sorts to close these up. You can use our mini glue dots, you can use Tombow, you could use Snail, Fast Fuse, you can use absolutely anything. And I just think it's beautiful. I love making matching envelopes to go with cards, as I think it just finishes it off. It looks really nice. Right, so now that that's done, I'm going to come in with my Tombow and I'm just going to use that. So I'm just going to fold in the two side flaps and run a bit of adhesive. Once it decides to come out, it's having my life this morning, isn't it? And then just fold that over, keep hold of it while it sticks, and now you've got. I'll go over that with my bone fold when I've done this one. Again, just a bit of glue, put that to one side. You can, if you want, snip these little bits off here, but I don't think I have on the other one, so I'm just going to leave them here. Oh, that one hasn't stuck. Doesn't want to stick, this one, does it? Give it a couple more seconds. Yeah, I think that's done now, and then I'd just like to go over on that side again as well, and you will see that our cards will fit perfectly in there. Like that. It's so cute. Beautiful. Right, now what I need to do is I'm going to get our decorative label punch, which is this one here, and I'm just going to punch out a couple of these. Just lined up. There's one and two. Put that to one side. And then just apply some glue glue all over. Not like me, is it? Right. Trying to get this video done. Oh, hand straight in the glue. Trying to get this video done as soon as I can, because my sister's due over to give me mum a Mother's Day present, and I don't want to catch me doing this because she'll just take the mick. Right, okay, so now that we have our envelopes done, just pop them down like that, bring our box back in, and we get our cards with our matching paper. So for this one, that's the envelopes I've got for here. So hopefully, this is the time of truth, how they all actually going to fit in. Now, oh, so there's that one in there. This one, these are the ones that go with the candles. I've used the reverse of the paper with this one and the presents. I should have done that with that one, so it would have looked a bit better, but you know, that was in hindsight really. So just pop them in. Now you might just need to get rid of that little lip bit, and then you can't go on top. And then again, your three envelopes in like that, and then our three matching cards will go in there just on the top. And then what we do is when we roll it up like that and fasten it, that is our finished product. I just really love it. It's really sturdy as well. I don't think the cards are not going to get damaged or anything in here. And like I said, I just love how it turned out. I'm definitely going to keep one of these in my bag for any people's surprise birthdays. I really hope you like how it turned out. And if you'd like to order any of the items, they're all available on my store, which you can find that on my blog, feancards.blogspot.co.uk. There's a shop now button. And also I'm on Facebook at feancards. So there's the two that we've... the one we've made today and my previous one. I really hope you like them. Thanks for watching. Bye.